to what's purported to be the Triffids radio show. At least it was advertised in various journals as such, but unfortunately Leah Hayes is not here at this stage, and so we're just filling in for her, and so we're going to play Jilted John now.
Bass player who's asleep at this moment back at our house and is unable to get here. Seems like no one's able to get here at all. Anyway, we'll keep the show running as smoothly as possible, and we've got Frank Sinatra with a fantastic little song that he recorded about 2 years ago. Or maybe that's 20. Someone doesn't know how to write O's around here. Anyway, Frank Sinatra really is a next-door neighbour who just happens to run a Korean restaurant, but he's got a recording career on the side. So here it is with Mademoiselle.
A small cafe, Mademoiselle. Mine, for you,
was Dream Baby Dream by a group called Suicide that existed for a while back then before they shattered and went their own separate ways. And the last I heard, I think Alan Vega is being produced by that horrible person out of the Cars, but still.
Now, I was listening to that and I was thinking, what's the name of this band, Suicide? You know, this must be the only 25-story building in Sydney without double-plate glass windows, I know, and we haven't received one of our royalty checks for $3.78 recently, and I'm getting a bit desperate. And
yeah, and so this radio show could be curtailed rather shortly. This is actually the Triffids, according to the Gospel of the Triffids radio show, and Leah Hayes, if anyone knows her telephone number, you know, feel free or put a letter bomb in a letterbox or something like that. We're going to go on now with a song that was once eaten by Elvis Presley. He liked it because it mentions fried chicken, and it's a Kris Kristofferson song sung by Johnny Cash, Sunday Morning Coming Down. Yeah, funny.
Well, I woke up Sunday morning with no way to hold my head. That didn't hurt. And the beer I had for breakfast wasn't bad, so I had one more for dessert. Then I fumbled in my closet, threw my clothes and found my cleanest dirty shirt. Then I washed my face and combed my hair and stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I'd smoked my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs I'd been picking. But I lit my first and watched the small kid playing with a can that he was kicking. Then I walked across the street and caught the Sunday smell of someone's frying chicken. And Lord, it took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. Sunday that makes the body feel alone, and there's nothing sure to dying that's half as lonesome as the sound of the sleeping city sidewalk. Coming down. In the park I saw a daddy with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And I stopped beside a Sunday school and listened to the song they were singing. Then I headed down the street, and somewhere far away a lonely bell was ringing. And it echoed through the canyon like a disappearing dream of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, die.
107.5. There we go. This is 2SER FM. Public radio at its best.
Yeah, well, we hope you enjoyed that little station ID there. And we have a book in the studio here. It's one of our favourite reading materials.
Basically the Bible, really.
Well, the Gospel according to Hans Holzer, who is the author of the book, which says on the front, "This book proves the continued existence of Elvis in the world beyond and reveals his existence in the afterlife." And the name of the book is Elvis Presley Speaks, which must be the first time because he didn't say a coherent word for the last 20 years of his life. I'm not going to read you any excerpts because it'd probably be censored automatically by the, you know, the Lord himself. And all I'd like to say is God bless Elvis, because no one else will.
Especially not Jerry Lee Lewis. You're a sick man, Jerry. I'm telling you now. 13-year-old girls and all, but no one's got a Cadillac collection like mine.
Very fabulous, sensual Sylvester and so forth, and his, her single. I think that person had the gender bender market cornered about 5 years ago, but still. Right, I guess we have to play some Australian music. Well, we don't, but we've got to play probably one Australian song in the whole 2 hours that we're on here. And so I think we've got to play a song called Just Skin by No Dance, and this is Brett Myers' song. Have you got anything to add to that, Elvis?
Yeah, well, I'm going to say it's 11:30, and
you're listening to 2SER. Listening to the inaugural perennial Triffids radio show. The next song you're about to hear is by the Reflections, and it's called Just Like Romeo and Juliet. But before that, sorry, I think we have a word or two about real estate.
Mm. Yeah, well, Dave and I are both qualified real estate agents, and we were thinking...
You notice by the width of our ties and the amount of... the food stains on our shirts.
And we look surprisingly like Greg Evans. But anyway, now, look, we live in this place in Redfern. Okay, you know, so a lot of people don't live in Redfern, they die there or whatever. But anyway, we're living there at the moment, and we're moving out, it's about Wednesday next week, and it's a extremely luxurious, spacious, fully appointed upstairs flat opposite the Federal Police and the TNT multinational corporation. And, in Lawson Street, Redfern, and we're moving out of Z on Wednesday next week, and we would like anyone out there who wants to move in,
because otherwise we'll lose our bond this week, which is $640, and it's not a particularly enjoyable thing. And we'll just describe the house to you. It's got seven bedrooms, it's got two kitchens, two bathrooms, and it's actually a wonderful and spiritually uplifting place to live, as I'm sure you'll agree once you go there. And so we'd desperately like any takers to ring us up and take the house, and this is not a joke or a prank at all. And the telephone number here is 218-993 or 218-994. And, well, you don't have to ring up and take the house. You can just ring up and abuse us or something.
You can throw a brick through the station window with a message written on it if you want, if that's appropriate.
Okay, anyway. So we might as well play the next song now.
Yes, Norbert. Yes, I did it.